So in a person with generalized dystonia, one of the most important things is to understand what the cause is of the dystonia. So typically one would do a range of investigations, which would always include a scan of the brain, but often many other tests, including genetic tests. Sometimes it is difficult to know why somebody has developed generalized dystonia, even after a lot of investigations. In terms of management, it depends a lot on what the underlying cause of the dystonia is, and also whether the person has other problems, other neurological problems, apart from the dystonia. In adults, generalized dystonia is often happening as part of a degenerative disorder of the brain, and that means there might be lots of other symptoms going on as well, for example, problems with swallowing or problems with memory, and one has to take that into account with treatment. So in terms of treatment, the main treatment options are to use medications. And so there are a number of different medications that can be used for treatment of generalized dystonia. That can include anticholinergic drugs, dopaminergic drugs, and many others. Then botulinum toxin injections can be used. Now, you can't give botulinum toxin injections to lots and lots of muscles. You have to choose a particular muscles, but some people with generalized dystonia, there may be particular problems where you might use botulinum toxin injections to treat that particular issue. And then in certain situations, deep brain stimulation surgery can be useful, but it's important there really to try and understand what the underlying cause is of the dystonia, because there are certain causes of generalized dystonia that do respond well to deep brain stimulation surgery, and there are others where it seems to be much less effective or not effective at all. And then rehabilitation in general can be useful for people with generalized dystonia. So that means being in touch with specialist neurophysiotherapists, often sometimes occupational therapists, speech and language therapists. Those people are often providing aids, might be communication aids, might be walking aids, etc., to try and manage the disability that somebody has from generalized dystonia.